All talks from the Awakening Soul series are available at soulcounseling.com.
If you place sex outside of God, if you make sex not godly, you've created a trap, a forever trap for yourself, because it's the sex. Sex is the fountain in the center of the Venusian man that Da Vinci painted, is the sexual fountain, the coming orgasm, the coming of orgasm, coming of energy of God. Till we get whole and healed and holy with this, healed just, holy means whole, healed, same word, to behold again, to behold the glory of God again. Your choice is, you live out another lifetime, slowly dying, fighting for your little piece of pie, or you reawaken to the glory of God. The missing piece is the heart, which is why the heart has been a serious place of contention. You look around today, the heart is made fun of at every turn. Men have been made fun of. Men who have heart are made fun of. To the point, this is a huge topic, on how the heart has been destroyed in man. But without the heart, we have no chance of living. That's why Christians are so intent on going, without Jesus, the world cannot survive. Because on a deep archetypal level, they know that Jesus represented, became the Christ, the heart, the only begotten Son. Yes, it's partially true. Now, turning that into proselytizing religion that forces your religionism down the throat of everybody else is a complete misuse of Jesus's teaching. And fear-mongering that you're going to get left behind if you don't accept our way of saying it is absolutely satanic. That's Lucifer teaching. Someone needs to say it. God doesn't use terrorist threats to get you to join him. Terrorizing you by saying you're going to go to hell or die horrible deaths or be left behind is absolutely not God's way. God's way is loving, gentle, and joy, playful, fun. Come back home. Enjoy. Enjoy nature. Enjoy beauty. Enjoy each other. Enjoy loving each other. That's God's way. The heart, represented by Christ, is the Christ, the crossing, the Christos. Cross, Christ, it's a crossing. When he reaches out his arms, he's making a cross. Right in the center of that cross is the heart, correct? The central pivotal point, the missing piece, is the heart. It is the regulator, it's like a dial on a radio. Which is why it's been mercilessly attacked. And people who have heart, we've been trained to laugh at them. Oh, you're too sensitive. Oh, did that hurt your feelings? We make fun of each other. The heart has always been made fun of. Heart has always been excluded and not invited in until after all the business has been concluded. Beaten and bruised with the fisted glove, he walks alone the morning after in his bloodied love. Heart is sacrificed. Heart is strung up on the cross and bled to death. That's what we've done. And if we don't watch it, we will lose the whole planet. If we don't watch it, the heart will die completely. We have to rebirth the heart. This was Jesus' mission. This is what every teacher's mission is. I am a heart spirit. Sometimes I'm an angry heart spirit. I'm a heart, you know, we've seen the softer side of the heart. But there's a harsh side of the heart. The heart feels very hurt. You know, that's when in romantic relationships or in matters of the heart, when someone is scorned or hurt, it can turn very vicious, very angry, very revenge-oriented. The Nazi energy is the black heart, the denied heart. If you deny heart, if you don't let heart be open, and it turns vicious and angry, it turns into the Nazi energy that wants to kill and eradicate that which it perceives against as being against itself. I mean, in a twisted way, the Nazis were talking about creating the thousand-year kingdom on Earth. But in a twisted, horrible way, by killing off people. I mean, it's, you know, it's the inverted, denied heart. Just like you take energy, you take a child, and if you twist and invert them, you don't let them flower, you create stunted, deformed growth. Well, the heart will destroy us. Our own hearts will destroy us if we don't let it flower. Look at the word flower. The signs are everywhere all around us if we open our eyes. The signs are everywhere all around us. The word flower, it's right there. Flower. It's a flow. It's a flower of life energy, of heart. Look at a flower. It is like a chakra opening. It's an energy center. It's got petals. The thousand-petal lotus is what the ancient Hindus and then Sanskrit and the Vedas, what they call the Sara Shastra, I think they call it, the crown chakra. It's a flower. The thousand-petal lotus shows the heart opening. It's a flower. It's a flower. Unless we let the heart flower through our creation, we're doomed. If you grow a sunflower seed in a little plastic box, it's going to be a one twisted, gross, inverted creation. If we don't let the flowing life force of God flower up through us, we get twisted, the twisted garden, which is what we have now. Drive on any bad part of town and see all the warehouses and the horrible and the junkyard dogs and the, you know, the prostitutes, the hookers, the drug deals. It's just horrible what we've created from the Garden of Eden, because we've denied the heart. We've denied the heart. And whenever the heart comes to visit, it gets crushed, mostly. When spirits were birthed and born into the earth, cycle of spiritual incarnation, we birthed out of the different chakras, the different energy centers in our body. Imagine it that you're giving birth to showers of sparks out of your body, out of each center. There were heart spirits born that came out of the heart chakra of God, if you will. God and Goddess, Mother and Father. And there were green showers, like on the 4th of July, the spark showers. Those heart spirits came with the... And we're all energies. Each spirit has the potential. We are the full spectrum of color. But we also are certain colors more. There are yellow spirits that are out of the solar plexus. They're more intuitive. There are blue spirits that are voice spirits. There are indigo spirits. We're hearing of the indigo children now. They're of the third eye. They see, they can prophesy, they see the future. There's violet and purple spirits, purple rain, the rain of kings. There's red spirit chakras. They're more into the earth. There's orange sexuality. We are the whole spectrum, but we're also some predominance of color. The heart spirits on earth generally are laughed at, made fun of. When men on planet earth have been convinced or shamed into not letting their heart express, not letting their hearts express, a man, picture a very, quote, successful, tough businessman here, you know, in the Western world, that is very tough, he's very smart, tough businessman. We have it so ingrained, we even have sayings like, it's not personal, it's just business, where somehow it's okay to be ruthless with each other because money is the almighty goal. We leave the heart out of it. Heart has always been excluded and not invited in until after business has been concluded, is a line from one of my poems and songs. Is that really healthy for all of us? To not have heart included when you're doing something as important as deciding where to spend billions of dollars of your budget? Is it healthy, wise, sound business practice to leave heart out of it? Of course not, and that's what we're doing. So we're going to reap what we're sowing, which is massive unemployment, massive starvation, massive desperation in poor countries of the world. That's going to lead to a third world war. We're right on the brink of it now. What can we do? We can open the heart in ourselves, because you opening the heart in yourself adds more to the collective energy that it, you can feel helpless and hopeless. What can I do about poor, starving African, you know, countries? You can open your heart and love, and that energy will touch the whole family of humanity. There's nothing that can stop you from contributing, whether you have money or time or not, doesn't matter, to the loving awakening of the heart back on the planet. You open your heart. You let the Christ, you let love, you let heart, smart love, wise love, not sappy love, wise love, back into you. Say, God, I want my heart to reawaken. Look what happens to the men who have had to shut their hearts down. The leading cause of death in America is what? Heart disease, heart attacks. It's the leading cause of death is heart disease. It's hitting us in our face. There it is. Of course we're missing opening the heart. And when the man who has to be tough, God bless him, we have to be tough. We're wallets. Men are wallets, let's face it. If you have money and you're a man, hey, you look really good to the women of the world, you know? We've put our trust in money. In God do we trust? Of course not. In gold, add an L there, G-O-L-D. In gold we trust is what we really trust in. We need to tell the truth about it so that we can change it. In gold we trust. For years, I've avoided having money so I don't have to deal with, you know, having people be attracted to me for money. I don't take money that seriously. Others do, and I've gotten really hurt by that. The heart. The heart tends to be innocent. I'll give you some heart people. Michael Jackson is an obvious heart person. Elvis Presley. Jesus Christ. An example of denied heart is Charles Manson, a throwaway child who grew up on the garbage heaps of our society. with a sensitive heart got so destroyed and messed up, he just wanted revenge. And he was able to attract people to him, just the way Jesus did. All the women, Charlie Manson, the cult, the whole thing. A piece of denied heart. Martin Luther King, a heart person, killed, shot in the head by those who don't want the heart to wake up. The Peter Pan thing that in psychological circles about the man not wanting to grow up is staying youthful and playful. Derogatorily used, meaning, oh, he's afraid of commitment or something. We're killing the heart everywhere, the youthful, playful heart. And without the heart, can the body survive? You know, the body can live without the brain, but it cannot live without the heart. The body can survive if the brain has gone vegetable dead, as long as the heart is pumping. But without the heart, same with you, with our spirits. Without the heart, this creation will not continue. Those beings interested in killing this universe, this draining this planet of its life force, want to kill the heart, and they do. And that's a whole nother long story. Earth is a heart free will zone where the heart's meant to be open, meant to share, exchange, love each other. Open free will love. That's what Earth is created as. There's an invasion on Earth. You can call it the fall of man. An invasion by unloving spirits that drain energy from other spirits. They are currently in charge of the Earth. My kingdom is not of this world. Yet, Jesus said, when the heart has come back and reigns on earth, when heart comes first, not power, not threat of violence. We're currently living in martial law on earth. Think of it. Where do you know on earth where there's not the threat of violence? What country do you know where you don't have police with guns? It's everywhere. We're living in an internment camp. Remember during World War II, we interred the Japanese because of, you know, we were at war with Japan and we interred them to keep a close watch on them. That's what's going on for the whole planet right now. We are an internment camp on Earth with the threat of violence and the gun everywhere. If I walk out the door right here where I am, take my clothes off and start laying naked out in the grass, the police will be here shortly with a gun on their hip. With a threat of violence, get up, sir. If you don't get up, we're going to handcuff you. If you resist, we're going to put guns towards you. So that's where we're at. We're living in an internment camp on Earth. And we're killing, draining the heart. Heart spirits are made fun of. I'm talking about heart today. Other spirits have their own problems. The heart spirits on earth a reflection of how the other spirits, the other color spirits, view the heart spirits. You're too sensitive. Oh, come on. You're a panty waist. You're a pussy. You don't want to, oh, you can't have sex with just anybody you want. Sex is not just a mechanical act for the heart. The heart has to feel love to have sex, which is the safeguard. The safeguard is to have the love present while you have creation energy flowing through you. If you do not have love present while you're creating new children, new babies, new universes, new arenas for life to express itself, then you're going to get what? If you don't have love present, the heart present, you're going to get what? Unloving creations. That's exactly what's happening on earth today. Doesn't mean you don't have nice, wild, raucous, lustful enjoyment sex. Yes, you do, but you make sure you have heart present. Without heart, there will be no peace. So when a large piece of male energy as a soul is incarnated, a strong man, but he is not allowed to express his peacockness, colorful, enjoyable, and the heartness, and the love, and the gentle heart. That's made fun of, and he's turned into a military general that has to suppress his heart and bark orders. Where does that heart energy go? Usually, it incarnates as his son. He gets a son that is overhearted or denied heart. And often that is expressing today collectively, and don't want to step on any toes of political spiritual correctness, but I will. That incarnates as a gay son. It is the piece of heart that the father can't accept in himself, and it's the gay son will reflect that to him and go, "Here, Dad, I'm heart, I'm loving." It's Richard Simmons. I'm using our public figures because it's easy to do archetypal representations that way. Richard Simmons is made fun of. Yes, he'll be on the talk shows with David Letterman, John Jay Leno, but the men sort of, put up with him as a goofball. We make fun of him. We make fun of the heart in its current state, in men, and even in the women. So we've rejected the heart and turned ourselves into steely, militaristic men. Pretty soon we'll turn to stone if we don't let the heart back in. We already are. We're turning into stone. And we're taking all kinds of pharmacological pills to shove our feelings down even further. We're playing a very dangerous game of destroying life on planet Earth. I am a voice, and there's thousands of us that are saying, this is not the way to go. Wake the heart back up inside all of us. You can do your part by waking it up inside of you. Father God, loving Mother God, all that is, open the heart back in me. Let that flower open into a flowing of your love and your energy through me, Father God. Look around you and see where the heart is throttled every day. I'm going to use Michael Jackson because it's his soft, tender Peter Pan principle. He's a collective representation for America of the how the heart becomes twisted to the point where he's not accepted in adult worlds. And he turns to the heart, which is still alive in children. And we have to mercilessly make fun of it. It's a very dangerous game we're playing when we're rejecting the heart to the point where it gets twisted. Yes, you may say it's gotten twisted in Michael Jackson. But look how beautiful it was to begin with. Watch early footage of him as a young boy, that innocence. It's what we did to Jesus Christ too, because Jesus the Christ was the heart. The heart is very threatening. Men are very threatened by heart. So are women. Women are a little more open to the heart, and they will fall in love with it because it's more deeply archetypal in the women. Men in general just tend to get very threatened by the heart and like to pay it off or kill it. Playing a very dangerous game, killing heart on Earth. We make fun of it. Consider it weak, naive. We will toy with it. The gay community is the lost heart of the men. Not all of them, and I can't make such broad general statements. Right? I can't say it's true everywhere. But in general, that is the missing heart. That's why it's acting out. They even call groups that act up or act out, right? Because men are so homophobic, the quote straight men of the world, then it's going to act up on the other end and sort of shove it in their face, so to speak. It's part of the human family. I'm not saying all of the gayness. There's nothing wrong with it. Of course not. Love is love is love. It expresses itself through whatever bodies there are. Love is love. The whole of the law is love, Jesus says. Meaning there are no rules except that it be loving. When the heart is denied, it pops up elsewhere. You cannot push down on something in the creation's in the creation without it popping up elsewhere. Without us getting real with the heart, without us, all of us, one by one, accepting the heart back into us, we will not have a heartful, a balanced creation on earth. We have to accept the heart back in. We cannot continue to crucify the heart as we did with Jesus the Christ, Martin Luther King, John Lennon, anyone that expresses heart. We cannot continue to crucify it and hope to have a heartful society. We're going to degenerate into a military prison camp, which we're very close to doing. You can help stop it. You can bring love back to the planet. You can bring God back to the planet. You can bring softness back to the planet. You can bring fun back to the planet by opening your heart with God. Just in your private place and time, say, God, come back into my heart. I love you. I want a relationship with you, God. Show me where you are. And start loving those around you. Start telling your truth. Confessing your sins, as the Christians call it. Say what you feel. Get truthful. Get honest. This is what I see. This is what I see. This is what I see. I want love. Tell God what you want. Tell yourself what you want. If you don't want to believe in God, talk to the greater humanity of all of us and say, this is what we need. This is what we want. Bring love back to the planet. Bring love back to the earth. This is what I want. Openness, love, caring, sharing. Yes. Let the heart take its rightful place. Let the heart mature. Let the heart become the guider, the transducer on the planet. Let heart come back and take its rightful place in all of us, in all of you. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Mother God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, love. Let this touch the people that listen to it, Father. Let them understand the heartfulness needed and that each of us can just do our part and bring heart back into our lives. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father.
All talks from the Awakening Soul series are available at soulcounseling.com.